Hello friends, welcome back to my channel. I'm here with another travel vlog. We went to Dubai for Eid holidays, stayed there in a resort for 2 nights and visited few places. We had pre-booked few attractions online. We'll give you the details throughout the vlog. So let's get started. It's 4th of June and Eid has been declared. It's 8 a.m. and we are having breakfast at Salam Bombay near the house. After this, we will catch a taxi and head to Abu Dhabi bus station. We were expecting a little rush due to the holiday season and so it was. Had to wait in the queue for half an hour and but we got to board the bus quickly as we were a family with kids. It's 10 a.m. The bus has left Abu Dhabi bus station. The kids might fall asleep, so see you guys in Dubai. It's 11:40 now and we have reached Dubai. We will get down at a bus stop near WTC. I do not remember the exact name. And now we will head to our resort. So we are staying at Roda Al Murooj Resort, a luxury hotel in the heart of downtown Dubai, near to the Dubai Mall and Burj Khalifa. I love this resort and it's our second time stay here with the kids in their residence. One can truly enjoy the feel and ambience of a resort style hotel in a city location. We are staying at their 2-bedroom residence apartment. We will freshen up now and leave for Dubai Mall. We made a booking online for visiting at the top Burj Khalifa and Dubai Aquarium and the underwater zoo at 1 p.m. Here we are at the Dubai Mall. It's just 4 minutes walk from the resort, but it's getting really hot in Dubai and 48 degrees is not for a leisure walk, so we took a taxi. Got the tickets. This is a combo ticket for at the top Burj Khalifa and the aquarium and the underwater zoo. I will give the link to buy the tickets online in the description box below. Buying tickets on the spot can get really expensive, so do check that out. She was instructing Kichu to hold my hand and not run around. I bet he didn't really hear a single thing she said. There is not much to say about the visit to the top. It has to be experienced. Throughout the journey to the top, visitors are entertained by a multimedia presentation of the exotic history of Dubai and the marvel of Burj Khalifa. This super fast elevator takes us to level 124 of Burj Khalifa within seconds, and the view inside the elevator, it's amazing. Wow.
ഒരു മിനിറ്റ് എത്തി ആര് വന്നു ലിഫ്റ്റ് മോളിൽ എത്തി. This is the top of Burj Khalifa.
Located on level 124 of the world's tallest tower, this observatory is destined to be the highlight of any visit to the Middle East. It's our first time here with the kids, so we are hell excited. Now I am going to take few videos and pics as this is a rare opportunity, so enjoy with me. Now we will grab some lunch. It's 2 p.m. already and the kids are very hungry, so are we. We'll then visit the Dubai Aquarium and Underwater Zoo.
Wow! Who is this? Kichu enna kadikkanai?
I have ordered some caramel crepe with ice cream and strawberries for the kids. So let's see how they make it.
Better to do it this way.
We are done with the lunch and we will buy the ticket here and move on to see the aquarium. The Dubai Aquarium is home to 140 species of sea life and offers many incredible ways to experience the underwater world. The giant 10 million liter tank at the Dubai Aquarium and Underwater Zoo contains more than 33,000 aquatic animals and the largest collection of sand tiger sharks anywhere. Here you can see some divers scrubbing the corals and rocks, and it takes lot of effort to keep it nice and clean for them to live and breed in. This is a 48 meter tunnel with the aquarium enveloping you from overhead and around. It's a complete fisheye view with sand tiger, sharks and stingrays swimming overhead.
Shark, shark. Odalle kanna. Ippadu nokku, ippadu nikku.
Kichu is a little tired with all the walking and now I feel we have to hurry a bit before he gets cranky. Meanwhile, Appu is enjoying his time with the fishes. So we are headed to the underwater zoo located just above the aquarium. This underwater zoo has penguins, piranhas, crabs, water rats, seahorses, jellyfishes and plenty more, so I am sure the kids will enjoy.
പക്ഷി പറക്കുന്നുണ്ടായിരുന്നല്ലോ, വലിയൊരു പക്ഷി. ഇത് അണ്ടർ വാട്ടർ സൂ. ഓരോ ടൈപ്പ് ഞാൻ പേടിച്ചു. Appu is having time of his life. Kichu is sleepy, so he is hurrying up to finish off and go to the room.
Where
is it? Kichu, show me a lollipop. Wow! Let's go.
It's 4:30 p.m. and we are back at the room. The kids and daddy are off to sleep. I'm making some tea for us and boiling milk for the boys. I have some supplies with me which I brought from home. This is the whole point of staying in a hotel apartment. The kitchenette is well equipped.
Are you? Enda kudikkena? Yeah. Yummy? Show me. It's nice. Yummy? Chippa?
It's 7:30 p.m. now and we are very tired to explore more, so we decided to stay at the hotel. I cooked few things for dinner, some oats for auntie, she is diabetic and prefers this every night. For kids and daddy, it is some home leftovers from the previous night. Palak paneer reheated in the oven and chapatis are the ready to cook ones. For me, it's one piece of whole grain
bread toast and veggie soup in a cup. I prefer to keep it light for dinner. It's 11 p.m. and the kids are far from sleep, I guess because they have slept well in the evening. It's 5th of June morning and 7 a.m. now. I am in the kitchen to boil some milk for the boys. Let me quickly show you guys the apartment before they wake up. Starting with the kitchen, as you can see, this is a well-equipped kitchen. I brought some tea, ready to cook curry, ghee, sugar, salt and basic things to get us going. With kids you never know, especially my kitchu is little picky while eating outside. He enjoys home cooked meal and I prefer having things handy for the boys. So this is the living area with a 6-seater dining table, a sofa set, TV unit and Abhishek sipping morning coffee and a great view of the Dubai Mall and Burj Khalifa. Let's go and check out the bedrooms. This is the lobby and there is a small washroom and a dryer room. Straight at the end are two bedrooms. This is the one with two single beds, a dresser, a wardrobe and a bathroom. And this is the other bedroom with a large king size bed, a TV dresser, wardrobe and a bathroom. All the rooms come with a good view of the mall. It's 10 a.m. now and we are ready for day 2 of this trip. Before that, we are heading for breakfast at the hotel restaurant.
Swimming pool alla. That's a bridge. Let's go. Mallote pona mallote.
Adu swimming pool de kooda illa. Ride onnu illa kanda. Oh aalund.
He? Endu undu nu? Pillade adu. Chumakke.
We will enjoy their breakfast buffet and head to our next destination. So this is it. This is Dragon Mart. The boy's 4th birthday is coming and we came here to buy a gift for their birthday. So hope to find something that interests both boys. Dragon Mart is the Chinese hub of Dubai. It's a massive dragon-shaped shopping complex where they sell everything from electronics to fashion to homeware to furnitures. So if you love shopping on a budget, then this is a must place visit in Dubai. And now they have Dragon Mart 2, which is dedicated to fashion, travel cases and toys, and they have this huge sale going on in the toys section. There is a long walk across this mall, so we have rented these car strollers to keep the boys busy. So if we are able to buy something for them at Dragon Mart 2, we won't go to Dragon Mart, the main one, and we will have our lunch here and go to the next destination from here directly. We are trying out some rides for the boys. They have been interested in these push scooters since long now. Appu changed his mind and now he wants this bike, and Kichu has also agreed for it. So we got them this bike, just one to be shared between the boys. Quickly stopped for some lunch at the food court, and after this we will go to our next location. There is a lot more to see in Dragon Mart, but the boys are already sleepy and we have one more place to cover today. It's 4 p.m. and we are here at the Green Planet at City Walk. Again, the tickets were booked online as on the spot will cost us more. The Green Planet is Dubai's very own tropical rainforest. With more than 3000 species of plants, animals and birds, this green oasis is a sanctuary of exotic flora and fauna.
This one?
Yes, this are from Amazon River. They are called Piranha, still a baby.
Oh. Piranha yaad hai, movie. Aad angal pariyo.
It's amazing to experience such greenery in the midst of extremely busy Dubai city, and where else can they think of making such a travel attraction? Obviously in Dubai.
Let us snake. Appu, this snake is thodanu and chechi.
We loved our time in there, and make sure to check online for their special exhibits like piranha feeding. We missed out on a few.
Yeah. Oh, red pickup car.
So we are done with Green Planet. It's 6 p.m. now and we will head back to the hotel. We are prepping to hit the pool now. Kids loved their last resort stay and swimming pool experience at Al Seif in Abu Dhabi in my last vlog.
There's swimming pool. Yeah.
Time for some dinner. We are having some ready to cook paneer curry with ready to cook chapatis. And husband got these Maggi packs from a supermarket below. He will be having that. Time for some masti before going to bed. See you guys tomorrow morning. We are at the restaurant for breakfast, and here is a glimpse at the breakfast spread. Up close and personal with the chef.
Take it. Another uncle. What uncle? Uncle de Peru, what is your name again? Anirudh.
We are checking out today and we will head back to Abu Dhabi. We had so much fun in this trip and kids are loving their birthday gift too.
Ara
inno
ba okay go ba
On the way, we stopped at outlet mall for some shopping and lunch. Outlet mall is a brand hub of Dubai where you get all branded items at reduced prices. And due to Eid, there are good sales going on in the mall.
Sorry.
Kids played in this play area for some time and meanwhile we did some shoe shopping.
No.
So this is the end of this vlog. We got back in the taxi and went back to Abu Dhabi. I hope you guys enjoyed this vlog. So see you guys next time. Bye.